afternoon. Welcome or welcome back to the Faculty of Music at the University of Toronto. My name is Ryan McClelland. I am Associate Dean, Academic and Student Affairs here at the Faculty, and I'm here to welcome you on behalf of our Dean, Elliot Kasama, who is out of town today and not able to join us. Thank you so much for coming. I hope you enjoy the masterclass ahead. We have a number of very talented singers who are going to perform for us today and also receive instruction by our distinguished visiting artist. Before I go any further, I would like to do a land acknowledgement. I wish to acknowledge this land on which the University of Toronto operates. For thousands of years, it has been the traditional land of the Huron-Wendat, the Seneca, and the Mississaugas of the Credit. Today, this meeting place is still the home to many Indigenous persons from across Turtle Island, and we are grateful to have the opportunity to work on this land. As you will have noticed, this event is called the Riki Turofsky Master Class, and is brought to you through the generous support that this graduate of our program has for opera, for the arts in general. And Riki is able to join us today, and I will invite her to the stage to make a few remarks and to introduce today's guest artist.
Thank you. Well, it's wonderful to be back here. It's great to be live. The last couple of years we have been watching this live streamed, and I am a graduate. When I was here, we really didn't have master classes, and now I've always felt how important they are, because after I graduated, I attended many master classes, and they made a big difference to my career. So I've been doing this, this is the 16th year of this master class. And it's very exciting to hear the young singers. It's also very exciting to have the wonderful masters, and among whom we've had Sandra Radmanovsky, Michael Shada, Adrian Pachonka, conductors Johannes Davis, and today we are honored to have Elliot Madore, who, I mean, often we think of masters as being somebody much older who brings their knowledge back to the younger. And Elliot is not exactly much older. I mean, for someone my age, he's a baby. I do know your age is 35, but he's extraordinarily experienced. He's teaching now in Cincinnati. I know he's an expert in the fabulous work by Carl Orff, Carmina Burana. He is going to be seen. I didn't understand at the time that it wasn't live, but Against the Grain Theatre is presenting a work specifically for him called Identity. And that's going to be broadcast October the 23rd, and I'm looking forward to seeing that. But at any rate, enough of me. Let's welcome Elliot.
Thank you, everyone. Can you all hear me okay? I've got this mic set up here. I think we can. Good. I'm seeing some thumbs up. That's good. Just to say, it's such a pleasure to be here, to be back at U of T. I've had the pleasure of coming here in the past and giving a few master classes, so you might be familiar with how I like to work and how I like to operate master classes. So specifically, I like to talk a lot about, to work on vocal technique specifically in this class. I think it's really important for the students to have the opportunity to explore different ways of thinking about technique, especially in this performance context. So that's really what I like to concentrate on, and I know that there are immensely talented singers at U of T, and so just to say, it's certainly a pleasure to be here and to have the opportunity to work with all of you. So with that being said, let's have our first singer.
Thank Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Lyndon Ledure, and today Christine and I will be performing Una furtiva lagrima from Donizetti's L'Elisir d'Amore.
Thank you.
got a beautiful, beautiful voice. I love the clarity that you sing with. I love the tenoral brightness that you have. I think that's really, really fantastic. You know, I did say that I wasn't going to talk too much about characterization, but I will say, you know, this is a happy moment for him, okay? So I just felt like you were just a little bit serious. You know, I think even though this piece, you know, is slow and languid, we still have to imbue it with that sense of joy, okay? So don't feel like it's plodding along. Still give it that sense of joy, that sense of movement, a sense of energy, okay? So that's one thing. I had the wonderful fortune of working with an incredible voice teacher, Marlena Malice, who I'm sure you're all familiar with. She's really, really wonderful. One of the things that she told me that I'll never forget, that good singing is one part getting a good sleep, the other part breathing and support, and vowels. Okay, vowels are extremely, extremely important. The way we think about vowels can really help set us up from a physical perspective in a really, really nice way. So there's just some specific vowels that I think you can think about. I think you can think about opening up your top just a little bit more, just in terms of the vowels. So, for example, ne-yo-ki, you were closing that, but ne-yo-ki, you can just think about opening that up just a little bit more. I think that's going to help you. So, with that in mind, can we just start this again? Let's give it that sense of energy, and then we're gonna as we move along here, I'm gonna talk about vowels as we go along. Okay, let's start right from the top. Okay, just a few bars before. That's you're singing that vowel closed. Can you just feel a much more sense of spaciousness in behind that vowel? Ooh, 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 ooh. Right. So just give me that sense of space behind that vowel as you sing it. Okay.
Yeah.
Like that can open up. So that was much, much better on that beginning note. Ooh, no, feeling like that had much more space. That was wonderful. Can you do that one more time for me? So that was fantastic. Quelle, just feel like you can open that up just a little bit more, right? Quelle festa. You can even think of that as an ah vowel, more so than an all vowel, okay? Do that for me one more time. Quelle.
Quelle.
No worries.
Quelle festa.
Can you just feel like you're sending that out into the audience, okay? So that there's always a sense of release at the ends of those phrases, okay? Never that you're holding that in for yourself. It's always that sense of generosity, okay? And that's gonna help with your breath as well, that you just feel like you're sending it out there, okay? Can we try that one more time? Can we just go from quelle festa one more time? It was wonderful how you open those vowels beautifully.
Quelle festa
Right. So that's a tricky place, right? That's a tricky place. So here, what I would suggest is, since you're going into a crescendo there, don't open up that vowel so much.
Okay.
Keep it a little bit more narrow, right? We're going right through, we're dealing with your passaggio right now, okay? So in the passaggio, we want to make sure that we're narrowing out the space, okay? Narrowing out the vowel, sorry.
Yeah.
Narrowing out the vowel, not narrowing out the space. And then you have somewhere to go. If you start open, you have nowhere to go with that vowel.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so just start, think smaller space, smaller, more narrow vowel, and then open it up into that crescendo, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Let's go from the che più cerca. Yep.
Che più cerca.
So fantastic, right? That's fantastic. When you start that narrow, and then it's just so satisfying when you just open up there. That's really, really wonderful. Where did we leave off? Sima. You gotta open your mouth. Okay. So we never want to think spread vowel at the top. Sima. There's nowhere, your larynx is gonna rise, there's nowhere for you to go, okay? Sima, we wanna think vertical, right? We wanna think vertical, and we wanna think bright, and inner smile, okay? So we're just gonna do that one more time. Sima, I want you to drop your jaw, relax, release that tension there, and just think like as if you were saying, thinking of the vowel father, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Right, really Italianate, deep ah vowel, okay?
Yeah.
Great. Just because it was so fantastic, can we do it one more time? Just so you get used to that space. Exactly.
Che più cercando io vo. Che più cercando io vo.
So you need to just really, really trust that sima, sima, just do the sima, sima. Really, really, don't be afraid to drop your jaw, okay? Really channel your inner Jonas Kaufman, okay? Okay, really, 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 just don't be afraid. We don't wanna force it down, but we wanna make sure that jaw is definitely unhinged, okay? And not carrying any sort of tension. And again, I will say, a lot of the things that I'm talking about today, this is all the credit to the singers. It's extremely difficult in this context to implement the things that I'm saying, okay? It's very, very difficult. It takes a lot of vulnerability and a lot of bravery. So we certainly need to commend all of the singers here today for really exploring, and especially in this context, okay? So let's just really, really, really be brave and vulnerable and just what would happen if we just let go of that jaw and we just really thought vertical, deep ah vowel. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Yeah.
Great. Can we just go from the ma right on there? Created a really, really special moment. It was gorgeous. And on that un solo istante, you really, again, you narrowed out that vowel, but you kept that space. So you let that space do the work for you. It was really wonderful. Can we do that one more time from un solo istante?
Un solo istante palpiti.
One more thing. So we have to remember, especially in the Romantic languages, you know, especially in Italian and French, we need to think pure, uninterrupted vowels constantly, okay? So, and this is an issue with English speakers in particular. You know, we speak with a lot of diphthongs, okay? that's almost our entire language, okay? We're constantly chewing our vowels, okay? And in our effort to be very diligent about singing the correct diction, we oftentimes cheat the vowel in service of the consonant. Mm-hmm. So a perfect example of when you said del, mm-hmm. right? You didn't elongate that vowel as much as you could have. Del. So it's just long, pure, uninterrupted vowel, very late, rapid, quick consonants, unless it's a double consonant, of course, right? But that's the idea. So just really, really elongate that vowel, and I loved that vowel choice was excellent. Okay, it was vertical. It was really, really very, very nice. So can we just do that one more time? Da da.
Del suo bel cor sentir.
Sorry. Oh, no worries.
I miei sospir confondere per poco a suoi sospir. I palpiti sentir confondere.
Great work. So just on all of those E vowels up top, can you really just think IH for me? Eh, okay, instead of E, right? So again, that goes back to this idea of we don't want to sing spread vowels up top. So okay? So let's just go back a little bit. Can we go from un solo istante palpiti from there?
Un solo istante.
Can you give that just a little bit more space?
Yeah.
Del
suo bel cor sentir I miei sospir confondere per poco a suoi sospir I palpiti
Good. And I'm going to stop you before we get to the climax here. So confondere. So really, we're in your passaggio here, right? And we want to conserve your voice as best we can, right? And so in that respect, really, if you can just think about all of these places when you're singing those Fs, that they're just a little bit more. Narrow, not so open. Okay, and again, think narrow space. Okay, and a lots narrow vowel and lots of space in the back. Okay, can we just go e party? Okay, and sorry, I'm gonna say one more thing. The spirit. So again, same thing. I want you to think really, really on that crescendo. Really closed vowel, right? A closed vowel so that you have somewhere to go. Mm. Again? Okay? Great.
I palpiti. I palpiti.
So, I palpiti. So it's really like right? I palpiti. And again, it's not pal. We don't want to be chewing that vowel. I palpiti.
I palpiti, palpiti sentir, confondere I miei co suoi sospir, cielo si può morir, di più non chiedo.
Can you just think, just give us a hint of a vowel there? Instead of chiedo, chiedo. Just, you know, really, really just open up a little bit there. It's so satisfying for us. Can you just, that was wonderful. That was wonderful. Wasn't that crescendo wonderful? It was so fantastic. Really, really wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Can we just go, oh geez, there's not a good place to go from. Not really. Would it be all right if we did it again? It was so fantastic. Why don't we just do it one more time? It was great. Yeah,
I palpiti.
So that note right there just got a little bit too forward for my liking.
Okay.
Just a little bit in the nose a little bit. Okay. So just think a little bit back and up for me, okay? Okay? So lifted okay?
I palpiti, palpiti sentir confondere I miei co suoi sospir
Sure, we're going through your passaggio. Mm-hmm. We don't want to, there's nowhere for you to go. Just think, okay. So you have somewhere to go, okay? That was really great. I loved how you opened up on that kid. It was fantastic. It was really, really wonderful. Yeah, not a good place to go from. Can we just go right on that? That was fantastic. I loved going into that. And then just really let go. Let us have it. Okay? One more time. Shy away from that, right? What if you just really, really, really released and went really, really toward? There's a split second. So hesitation for any opera singer is deadly. Listening to yourself is deadly. If we take a split second to listen to what we sound like, we're in trouble. We're in deep trouble. So it's really about trusting your body, trusting your instrument, and so much of what we do as singers, almost all of what we do as singers, is getting out of our own way, okay? Getting out of our own way, releasing tension, getting rid of tongue tension, jaw tension, shoulder tension, and making sure that our natural instrument is resonating as freely and beautifully as possible, okay? So in this instance, we're checking in, okay? Don't check in. Okay. Just create that space, know where you want to go beforehand, and just do it, okay? Easier said than done, but let's give it a shot. Can we go from the same place? I love what you did there. That was fantastic. To be able to do that in this context is so wonderful, you should be very, very happy with that. And again, that sense of non-hesitation and trusting your instrument and trusting, you know, we've been doing this for even the students here have been doing it for a long time, been singing for a long time. You know, our bodies know what to do, right? We have to be able to trust ourselves at some point, okay? And especially in this kind of context, in this performance context, we have to let go. We have to trust, we have to let go. You know, because that's the name of the game, right? That's the name of the game. So that was fantastic. I'm not gonna let you go just yet, okay? Okay, I'm sorry. I'm very, very sorry. I just wanna tackle those pianissimo moments at the end, okay? And I think what's gonna help you is if you can just think, again, I don't want you to think about dynamics specifically. When you're singing a piano, I want you to think closed vowel And then when you sing crescendo, when you go into that crescendo, I want you to think open vowel.
Okay.
Okay. So, is there somewhere that we can go just after, or you know what, we got to do the whole thing again. I'm sorry. We have to do it all again. Okay. Let's go from the cadenza. Let's go from the cadenza. Okay.
No, from just the cadenza. Okay, there we go. Non chiedo si può morire.
So much. Thank you. And thank you. Wonderful. Okay. Hi.
Hello, everyone. My name is Lissy Merwitz, and today Spencer and I will be performing Smania Implacabili from Mozart's Così fan tutte.
Oh, dear.
You've got a gorgeous voice. Really, really wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. And you do something so naturally that a lot of mezzos have difficulty with in this piece, which is your access to the top is exemplary. You have such an easy top. Really, you put everything in the right place. It's fantastic. So, Dorabella, okay? She is the most melodramatic character imaginable. You sing so wonderfully. I want to empower you to really dig in here, especially in the recit dramatically. Mm-hmm. I want to feel like you're having a panic attack.
I'm close.
Yeah, okay, good. All right, good. Then we're on the right track. Okay, perfect. So even right at the beginning, I want you to breathe into that state of panic. Oh, it's Costa, right? And just smack us with that note.
All right.
You know, and just, I want you to have, you know, the thing with comedy that really makes it really funny is when it's actually true in a way, when it's really serious, if you really are experiencing these, very, very intense emotions with your fiance going away off to war, right? So, can we just start the recit one more time?
Sure.
And let me just see you breathe into that space, okay? So beautiful. My goodness. It's fantastic. It's fantastic. I want to, as soon as that note is played, I almost want you to interrupt it.
Okay.
Yeah. So you can't wait to get this emotion out. You know?
Yep.
Okay? Especially in Mozart recit, you are in control, okay? Even if you're singing with the orchestra in a recitative, you're still the arbiter of. It's almost like you're driving the drama, right? You are in charge, okay? So I just want you to take control of this recit,
okay.
And what you just did there when you started, it was so. It was fantastic. I loved it. I loved it. I loved it. So, yeah. Yes.
Yes.
One more time. But that's where I want you to go.
I got
him
carried away.
No. It. I mean, she is getting carried
away.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the point, right?
Yeah.
I mean, she's.
I'll just start crying just then.
Yeah. I mean, but she, you know, she can't control her emotions. She can't control herself.
Yeah.
You know, that's what she's going through right now. That's what she's going through. She's overreacting to the extreme. Mm-hmm. Okay, and it's not that you need to show us necessarily, you know. It's not that you need to have these grand gestures and show us, but if you can internalize, you know, speaking from experience, you know, I know, you know, certainly to feel a sense of panic sometimes, you know, oftentimes we don't actually show it, It's just going on inside and nobody knows that we're actually panicking, right? So it's not that you actually have to show it, but I still need to see that impetus, okay? I still need to see that energy going on, okay?
Yeah.
Great. And you can show that with your voice, which is so glorious, okay? Take time to really think about what you're saying there. Am I really saying that? God, I hate myself?
Yeah.
That's pretty intense, right?
It's pretty intense.
Yeah. So let that land a little bit more. Okay.
Okay. Sure.
Okay. Right? Just a little bit before.
Yeah, we'll do a Lelouche?
Yeah, sure.
I'll give you this deal before I go.
Okay.
Yeah.
And this is why I say with Mozart recits, okay, so much is said in the silence. So much, there's so much going on in the silence. Use that to your advantage. You know, when there's, you know, if, when, you know, I've had the pleasure of singing Giovanni numerous times, and you know, it was just this last time that I did it, and that was the ninth production that I'd done, okay, but meaning. It took me that long to understand how to use the silences to my advantage, and how to create tension, and how to create meaning out of it,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Yeah.
So what you just did there was so, so fantastic. And again, it's all of us, as singers, really taking license of what we're doing and making bold choices that might not necessarily work, but it's a choice nonetheless, and people will be interested.
Mm-hmm.
They will be interested. What is she thinking there? What's going on there? Uh-huh. Okay. Yeah, no, anyway, sorry, I'm talking too much. That was fantastic. Let's go, same place. Take your time there, right? There's no rush. And then the question is, who's going to console me? I would say pace yourself a little bit better. I like the choice there. You were it felt a little bit on the angry side.
Yeah.
Who's going to console me?
Yeah.
Which, I like the choice.
I like that choice.
But I'm just wondering, logistically, it's not going to leave you a lot of room to go.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So maybe they would keep that. Can we just try that?
Sure.
See if that works.
Yeah,
perfect.
I'll give you the thing before.
Okay.
Wait.
Wait longer.
Wait a little bit longer. Let's see what that feels like. Let's play with the silence. Let's see what that feels like.
Okay.
If it doesn't work, we don't have to do it. But let's just see what that feels like. Give us that tension. One more time. Can you internalize that more?
Yeah, I didn't do what you told me.
That's okay. You don't have to. It's fine. It sounds beautiful. That's great. I love that. But let's internalize that. Who's, you know, ask yourself that question.
Sure.
Who's going to console me? You know, and that's why I love Mozart recit, because of there can be endless possibilities, endless. Every phrase can have some iteration of some emotion, and we can choose to bring that out depending on the day. Mm-hmm. Maybe one day you're a little bit angry. Maybe you want to bring that out a little bit more.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the beauty of it. You can play. Fuji. So even though that's a double consonant there, I still need to hear some sense of the vowel. Yeah, because we need, the emotional impact is gonna lie in us being able to hear your voice resonate.
Yeah.
Fuji, fuji. So just give us just a little vibration going on
here,
okay? Sola, just that needs to elongate just a little bit more. Sola, sola, just so that the primary accent is on that note. Sola, sola, okay?
Yeah.
Sorry. La, shami, sola, just do that for me.
La, shami, sola.
So, I don't want to. So, sola, no. Sola, right? Sola. To me, like you're just shying away a little bit.
I am.
Why?
That's a good question.
Okay. So that same sense, Fuji per pietà, I want that same space that you're singing with there, that same intensity, that same drive, that same sense. I want that to be here. So even though it's you might be thinking a little bit on the staccato side
I'm
of things.
I'm thinking about the rest, that's why.
Don't worry about those. It still needs to be sung.
Mm-hmm.
We still, again, the emotional impact lies in us being able to hear the resonance of your voice.
Mm-hmm.
So the more that you're shortening those notes and clipping those notes, which is fine, but we still need to hear your voice blossom for us to understand what you're doing and what you're saying. Okay?
Yeah.
One more time. Do me a favor. Just sing it without the rest. Okay? Just sing it without the rest. I just want you to just let it out. Okay? Okay, so that's not actually so far away from what we want. Okay? That's actually pretty close.
Okay.
So now, do you have the sense of that line? Okay? Great. So keep that in your mind as you sort of integrate that sense of staccato, okay? And of dealing with those rests as well, okay?
Yep.
Small, one more time.
I did it again.
Yeah. It's you're losing the sense of direction.
Okay, yeah.
Right?
One more time.
Yeah. Your breath and your breathing and all of those things. It seems like it's getting a little bit...
It is. I stack.
You stack.
I need to.
We all stack. I stack. Yeah. It happens to all of us. The important thing is to remember when we breathe, right, we need to have a sense of release.
Yeah. To let
so
it go.
You have... Exactly. You have to let it go. Feel that anchor drop, right? You're taking that really, really good breath. So just... We're gonna do this one more time and just feel like every single, at the ends of every single phrase, you release.
Okay.
You're starting over. Okay?
Yeah.
One more time. Phrases, you gotta give it to us. Mm-hmm. Don't feel like you're saving that for yourself. Feel like that's an external motion, that you're sending that sound out to us. Sending it out. Don't hold it on for yourself, okay?
Yeah.
That was great. Much better. Did you feel the breath working for you?
I did.
It's great. It's great. Really, really good. Let's go from the top of small.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, I'm going to say one more thing. Just the top of that note.
Yeah.
Can you just open up that bell a little bit more? Just ah. Right. You generally do it. This time it was just a little bit Just open it up. Suggestion. I feel like every time you start, you're not, you're finding the space after you start singing the note, right?
Yeah.
So can you prepare the space in your breath, right? So that it's already there, so that you're already starting with that sense of spaciousness and that you don't have to find it afterwards. Mm-hmm. Already there.
Yeah.
Okay?
Sure.
Can we just think about that? It's great. Great. Same place.
Good.
we're sort of delving into technique land here. But I did notice in the first iteration of this, it's beautiful, it's musical, it's wonderful, but again, I just need to have a sense that you're hyperventilating.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Right? So I need that, I need you to imbue that with that sense of intention as well.
Sure.
Okay? I know I'm asking you to do a lot.
No, that's okay.
You're doing wonderfully. Really, really wonderfully, wonderfully. Let's do that one. That sounds great. Yep.
Put
a
swoop, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll do the damage. So,
cool.
One, two.
Put a swoop. Maybe that's a bad place to start.
Like before, say viva resto.
Right.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, here we go. So, one, two, one.
Say viva resto. Put a swoop on the
road. Yes. Yes, it's fantastic. Did you all feel that? That was wonderful.
It's
beautiful.
I love that.
Yeah. Really, really great. Let's keep going. Somebody will stop me, I'm assuming. 5 minutes. Okay. I always run over time. Okay. Right. Let's keep going. Let's keep going.
Here's the interlude to the next night.
Yep.
Don't do that.
Yeah.
You're robbing us of that gorgeous voice of yours, okay?
Just one before.
Yep.
That is opera, right?
Yeah.
Generosity of sound, okay? Same place?
Hey,
Sempio?
Yeah.
Okay, here's the
measure.
So,
two. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I'll give you two.
Wow.
I'm just giving the whole interlude.
Okay, cool.
No worries.
Christine and I will be performing Vi Ravviso from La Sonnambula by Bellini.
Do you want my copy?
I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay. Here, take mine. That's okay.
So this is Vir Raviso from La Sonnambula by Bellini.
Fonte, il bosco è vicino alla fattoria.
So I've had the pleasure of working with Luke a few times over Zoom, and so this is actually my first time hearing Luke in person.
Yeah.
So it's certainly quite a pleasure, and isn't it wonderful to be having live music, live performances? It's so wonderful, really, really wonderful. You've got a great sense of this piece. Really, really nice. I like your dramatic intention. It's great. It's really, really great. I want to play around with having more sense of legato, okay?
Yeah.
More sense of singing through those vowels, and then also not cheating the shorter notes.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Really giving them their full value, not just rhythmically, but with your voice, and really singing into them and using them, not viewing them as a hindrance, but using them as a help, almost. Okay, can we just go from the top, and I'll sort of show you what I mean.
Sure. The rest.
Yeah, the rest. Yep.
Il mulino, il fonte, il bosco, e vicin la fattoria.
Can you feel like that? So I understand the logic of backing off there, but I actually would prefer that you do the opposite.
Okay.
Can you just feel again, just like you're singing, the note, the way the phrase is constructed, there's going to be a natural decrescendo anyway,
right,
because you're going lower. Okay.
Yeah.
You're descending there, so there's no need to actually add on a sense of backing off, right?
Okay.
It will do it naturally. And so if you stay on your voice and you sing that out, it's going to achieve the effect that you want, and also we're going to hear your voice, right?
Okay.
Okay. One more time?
Yep.
Il mulino, il fonte, il bosco, e vicin la fattoria. Ravviso o luoghi ameni.
So even that, for example, o luoghi ameni. You're doing what I call sort of sausaging a little bit.
Right.
Okay?
Yeah.
So just feel like there's a consistent sense of tone.
Yeah.
All the way through those vowels, okay?
Yeah.
You don't need to make it any more beautiful than what it already is, right? If we simply sing what's on the page, it always works every time, right?
Yeah.
So let's just go from via viso. Let's do that.
Via viso, o luoghi ameni, in cui lieti.
So that's fantastic. That's really nice. That's really nice. Did you all hear that? That's really, really great, right? Fantastic. The next thing I want to tackle, those E vowels, okay?
Okay.
Can we just give a little bit a sense of roundedness to those E vowels? So just like you're singing it through that a German Ü umlaut. But you're singing an E into that vowel, so it's not E, but V, V. So there's a sense of color and a sense of roundedness, and we're not spreading that vowel, okay? And in that way, it's going to be in line with the rest of our vowels. Okay?
Yeah.
E vowels are tricky, because they're vastly, vastly different from the rest of the vowels,
right,
in the sense that they can become very, very spread, right?
Mm-hmm.
So let's just tackle that, okay, quickly. Good. Wonderful. E vowels, great. Now just sing through that.
Yeah.
Right, so that you're giving all of those short notes the full value of your voice, okay?
Okay.
Great.
Vira viso, o luoghi ameni, in cui
is so fantastic. So that the spaciousness that you have there, and that sense of release, and that sense of generosity, would it be possible to fit all of the vowels in that same space?
Yeah.
Maybe?
Yeah. Okay.
So if we can just think of those E vowels. So just that everything has that same amount of space as yeah. when you really opened up there.
Yeah, okay.
Can we try for that and
yeah.
see if we can find and really let go of everything, mm-hmm. right? That sense of release, okay? Let's
yeah.
try to find it, okay? Let's try to find out. Space that you're going to sing for the passage.
Yeah.
Right? Okay.
Yeah.
Can we just go from there? It's fantastic. No. So that's close. Okay. So you feel that space on that
yeah.
vowel, right?
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm
just
gonna look at your tongue.
Sure.
Can you do
that
one more time?
Yeah.
And can just relax your jaw.
Okay.
Bye. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Out there, that sense of resonance when you get that, it's really great. So here, just make sure that you're singing those, singing through those shorter notes, okay? Right. Yeah.
Right. Can we just do it? Can we go from ka ri lo gi?
Yeah.
Ka ri lo gi.
Just sing an ah vowel for me, okay? I just want you to experience the space, and then we're gonna go back and narrow out that vowel a little bit so it's more Italian, okay?
Inguilia, inguilia.
Right, so I want that space.
Yeah.
I really want that space.
Yeah, okay.
Inguilia. Yeah. So just try to retain that space and just narrow out that vowel for me, okay?
Yeah, okay.
In Quilio,
yes,
yes. Prima
gioventù. Great. so can you just feel like that's energized a little bit more?
Okay.
Right? Just engage your support and go. Okay. Just do one quick thing for me. Yeah. Can you just think just a little bit more lifted? That right now is just a little bit too far back and a little bit too pressed down. Just a little bit more lifted, okay?
Yeah.
Let's try. Good. I want you to just feel like that whole phrase is just you're letting go of your job.
Yeah, okay.
Just really, like, I want you to feel to, and in this space, in this context, it's great if we can just be really vulnerable there.
Yeah.
What would happen if you just have the slackest, loosest jaw that you can that you can have? Okay.
Yeah.
What would happen? Let's try it. Let's try it. So just, I don't want you to feel like you need to make that low note happen.
Yeah.
That you have to press on it,
yeah.
Okay? I want you to think spacious.
Yeah.
And forward,
yeah.
Okay? So lift that, so just think of those low notes as if you were singing a high note, okay?
Yeah.
And you're giving it that same amount of space and just try to just encourage it forward a little bit,
okay?
Let's give it a shot. Una credenza. Lift, same place as you did before. Same thing as you did before. Just from that E flat non tro.
Non tro.
And don't be afraid to send it out.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
Can you do that one more time?
Yeah.
Da, 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 and just
non tro.
Breathe.
Non tro.
Today, Spencer and I will be presenting Il Bel Sogno from Puccini's La Rondine.
incredibly beautiful. So, so, so beautiful. I mean, you really have those money notes there. Really, really, truly, that's really fantastic. If you could think of a, in just one word, one primary emotion that you'd be feeling for this piece in general, what would it be?
Hope.
Nice. Okay. You know, one of the most difficult things to do is to hold an audience's attention in a long musical interlude. It's difficult. It's really difficult to know what to do.
Yes.
And so sometimes we have a tendency to sort of wander or get distracted or think about what our next note is going to sound like.
Yep.
But. You know, I worked with Stephen Wadsworth, who works at a Juilliard. He always told me a wonderful idea, which was to really think of one primary emotion and think of a moment in your life where that emotion was exemplified. And to just sort of have that image in your mind play almost like a movie reel during those musical interludes. So if you can, you don't have to share it with us, but if you can reach back into your memory bank and just be there with that moment and just see it. And I promise you, if you're still and if you're quiet and if you're there with that thought, you're gonna reel us in. Mm-hmm. Can we just try that? And that was beautiful playing, by the way.
From the beginning.
I just want to hear and see that thought process, okay? Also, you know, another good word for it is to be in a flow state. Mm. You know, to really be, it's so difficult as a performer to be present. Mm. You know, because we have so many things that we have to deal with. You know, in an opera or if we're doing a concert, there's so many things and so many issues that we have to deal with. But the more we strip that away, and the more present we are here, now, not somewhere else, it can become a really special thing for the audience to feel. So that there was you being extraordinarily present, and you pulled us all in. And so we were just, we couldn't wait to hear that next note, mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah.
Great, great. All right, let's sing a little bit. Beautifully sung, I love the vowels, I love all of that. But I my sense is that you're hitting every single note. So just feel like there's a sense of subdivision between each of those notes. So that energy is constant. Right, so just and that sense of support and energy throughout that whole phrase, so you're not hitting those notes, but that you're feeling that energy throughout. Does
yes.
that make sense?
Yes.
Great, let's try.
Oh.
Shut it up. You don't. I mean, Puccini is. I mean, the music itself is so unbelievably musical. You don't need to add your musicality to it.
It's there.
It's just there. Yeah. It's just there. So, you know, and I see this very, very often with students. They feel it's sort of a duty to impart their musicality on the piece instead of simply singing what's on the page, right? Yeah. And so it feels like you're being unmusical when you actually are just simply singing the piece, but in actual fact, it's much more musical, right? So that was fantastic. I love that opening phrase. It's gorgeous, beautifully sung. Let's try it one more time, okay? Can you speak it for me?
Studente in bocca la bacio.
Right. So there's a lot of you've got a lot of words to fit into, you know, a short amount of time.
Yeah.
So, but irregardless, I need more vowels and less consonants. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So just really try to elongate those vowels, even though you're singing really, really short notes, okay?
Okay. Yeah.
But can we just try that? I'm un giorno. Start on time. We're going to start on time. One more time.
I'm going to ask.
Oh, please.
I want to have a sense that you're, it's almost like you're plucking a string. I feel like you're tiptoeing into that.
Okay.
See, like, oh, how do I sound? Oh, yeah, it's good. Okay, here we go. You know what I mean? But instead of just going, just sing it. Do it again? Sorry,
yes,
I didn't mean to speak.
No.
That was wonderful. It was really, really great. I loved it. One more time. Don't tiptoe into it. Just, what would happen if you just sang it? Just sing. What would happen? I just want to see what would happen. If you just opened up that vowel slightly.
Okay.
Just a little bit more of an ah-ish.
Okay.
Open, a little bit more ah-ish, ah-ish. A little bit more open. Let's just see. Let's just see, okay? Let me give her the lead.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you. Every time? Whoa, holy smokes. Yeah. Whoa. That was great. Whoa, that was great. That was great. Let's keep going. That was fantastic. And you know, I like the inclination to start, you know, piano, pianissimo, yeah. Right? I like that inclination. But if we do that, I want you to feel like you're plucking a string. Instead of that you're just tiptoeing into it. So just feel like you're creating the space and then pluck the string.
Okay.
Can we try? Just on that second upward trajectory into that decrescendo, can you still, even though you're going into that note, can you just have a sense of, I don't want to hear you hesitate.
Yeah.
I love the color, I love the pianissimo, but I just want to feel like it's suddenly appearing out of nowhere.
Okay.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay, let's give it a shot, okay? Okay.
Both times again?
Yeah. Firstly, just going up into that crescendo, into that decrescendo was just magical. It was really very, very, very special. My sense is, you know, when you go back down into your middle voice, I'm just wondering if you can have a sense of a little bit more spaciousness and a little bit more inner smile and a lift. Okay? So the same way that you sing your high notes, I would just encourage you to have that same feeling for your middle voice.
Okay.
The same amount of energy that you're creating, that same sense of velocity and speed with your support and your breathing. Can we have that same...
Yes.
Can you match that up a little bit more with your... Because I feel like suddenly once the high notes are done, you're like, I can just relax a little bit. But I don't want you to relax. I want you to keep that same kind of energy throughout, okay?
Can you work that?
Mm-hmm. That's great. So you're tiptoeing in. Start there. Yes.
Exactly.
exactly. I like bright, I like bright, I like clarity. But you know, it's the same as the old Italian adage, you know, chiaroscuro, right? You need to have bright and dark.
Yes.
We need to have all iterations of our voice, right? We need to have the upper partials and the lower partials.
Okay.
Right? Yeah. To get a really full 3D picture of what your voice is.
Yeah. Okay?
So I'm just gonna ask you to keep that brightness, keep that clarity, but just think. Oh. Okay?
Okay.
And that was so much better. So much better. That kind of energy, you need to carry that energy through, especially in the middle voice.
Okay.
Really important. Okay? Let's do that from the same place, same spot. Okay. Just noticed that your tongue suddenly, as soon as you did that, went all the way back. Okay? All the way back, okay? Can we just try that one more time? And just make sure that your tongue is touching your bottom teeth, okay? And not being yanked back, okay?
Yeah.
So just okay, let's just try that one more time. Same spot, same spot. I want to hear that middle voice energy again.
Okay.
That's fantastic. Singer's existence.
Yes.
As we all well know. So making sure that the tongue is not flattening out in the back of our throats is of utmost importance, because it really can, it almost serves as like a blanket over our resonance. So we need to make sure that the tongue is always in a slightly lifted forward-ish position. Okay, generally speaking, we don't want it to be flat, and that happens a lot when we sing ah or oh vowels, right? The tongue flattens at the back. So what you just did there was great.
Okay,
can I try one more time?
Yes, yeah.
That's great. Let's just try somewhere. Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
So you gotta start energized, right?
Yep.
You can't get into it after. You gotta start, ready to go, okay?
Thank you.
My name is James Cole Stevenson, and today Christine and I will be performing Au vin de si belle tristesse from Ambroise Thomas' Hamlet.
Would it be possible for you to take off your glasses? Would that be possible? Can you see okay? Is that is okay? So it's just because as a performer, we need to be able to see your eyes. Your eyes, you know, are the window to your soul, right? We need to be able to see, and so when you have something impeding that, you're not inviting the audience in that sense, okay?
Well, I can't see the audience right now, so.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, sometimes actually when I perform, I don't put in contact lenses. So because then everybody's a little bit blurry and then I don't have to worry about seeing the audience or something. Anything strange, so.
I'm looking and I genuinely have no idea what's going on.
Okay, well, you don't have to do that. You can put your glasses on back if
it's
you want.
Fine.
But just generally when we audition, yep. And when we
absolutely.
Do that, just to make sure that you're not wearing glasses. Okay, I want to talk a lot about vowels, okay? So, you know, French is tricky. French is tricky because we oftentimes really want to sing those closed French vowels, but they're not exactly conducive towards good resonant singing, right? So I just want to feel, if we can just start one more time, and just in general, and we'll stop and start as we go along, but just to get that general sense of spaciousness, okay, in the French language, okay? Just a couple bars before. So that's it. So right off the bat, right?
Yeah.
So this, right.
Yeah.
Right. So just that, even though we're singing that French nasal, that there's a sense of tons of spaciousness in the back.
Yeah.
Right? So that's, let's just start one more time. And just give us tons of space in the back, okay? More legato.
Absolutely.
Okay. That was fantastic.
Thank you.
It was great. It was great. You really added a lot of space. It was much more resonant. It was much. It was great.
I think it was first time nerves.
Could be. But also you the way you shifted the vowels there was really fantastic.
Yeah.
Okay. It was great. From the top one more time, if you don't mind.
Absolutely.
Much more vertical, it had much more height, it was much more lifted.
I agree.
And I'm wondering, once again, if we can just fit everything into that space, it would be ideal. I felt like this time around, it was a little bit too much of pushing forward instead of allowing the resonance to be, okay? You know, singing forward, though it might be very tangible for singers. It's a very tangible thing, which is helpful because singing is so elusive, shall we say, right? And so the idea to sing forward is very comforting. But oftentimes what happens is there's a tendency, when we do that, we have a tendency to push. Mm-hmm. And when we push and when we force something, we're losing resonance, right? So I want to start one more time. And I don't want you to feel like you're driving the sound. I want you to feel like you're releasing into a sense of resonance, okay? Let's try one time. Can you just feel like you're sending that sound back? But you're not giving yourself any space, so there's nowhere to go. Good. that's fantastic. That was great. And I just want you to have a sense of, instead of tilting everything slightly this way, can you just feel like it's a little bit more central? Does that make sense? So that you're sending all of the vowels and all of that energy and all of that support to the top of your hard palate.
Oh, okay.
And so that the sound is not this way, but just more through the top of your head, this way, straight up, okay? Does that make sense?
So, yeah, it does.
Okay. Because what I'm feeling now is I'm just feeling like there's a sense of there's too much forward action. And so we're missing out on a sense of backspace and depth in your voice a little bit.
Yeah.
And so I just want to get it a little bit more central.
Certainly. Okay.
So let's just tilt it back slightly. Up, up and back. Making anything happen, we're allowing
it's
it to
okay
happen.
If I get my glasses.
Oh my goodness, yeah, of course.
I really cannot see a thing.
I apologize.
So much better.
Good. Okay, let's go. Do sa.
Do sa lika.
Yeah, no.
Do.
Do.
No.
Do. Open up that vowel. See, that's a perfect example. Yes.
Do sa lika.
A great French diction coach told me, sing the pure vowel and then just add the French nasal at the very end.
Okay.
Do, 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 mon coeur.
Yeah, that actually feels so much better.
Yes. You know, I mean, singing in French is not fun. It's not fun, you know? I mean, it has such beautiful music, but if we, you know, nobody wants to, you know, come to a performance to hear a great French diction. You know what I'm saying? Nobody's coming to they want to hear your voice first and foremost. So if you're sacrificing your voice for the diction, we've got an issue.
Yeah.
Right? It has to be the other way around. Right? The diction has to fit, you know, has to fit your voice. It has to fit the resonance that you want to create. Okay?
Absolutely.
So that is a perfect example of a wonderful compromise, right? Wonderful compromise that's going to make everybody happy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Great. All right, let's do the B section.
Perfect.
La vie est sombre, les gens sont
fantastic. It's really great. I feel like at the very beginning, La vie est son, son, la vie est son,
sombre.
Yeah.
La vie est, just relax your jaw. La vie est sombre, les ondes en cours. So that there's more space, there's more space. It's still going to sound French, I promise. You don't have to make it sound French, okay? It will, you have excellent diction. It will be there, but we need more spaciousness.
Yeah.
Okay?
La vie est sombre, les ondes en cours. Que nos bons jours, Dieu sait le nombre.
De nos bons jours, jours. So that's a little bit too. And that's you tilting back slightly.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, yes, 100%. Mm-hmm. Yeah, great. Can we do the whole thing again? It was great.
Absolutely.
La vie est sombre, les ondes en cours.
I still think you can get to a much more spacious place.
Yeah, I agree.
It closes down. La vie. La vie.
La vie.
Yes, there it is.
Yeah.
There it is.
Yeah, okay.
Right?
I can do that.
Great.
La vie est sombre, les ondes en cours. De nos beaux jours, Dieu sait le nombre. Chacun est l'os fortissima, sa lourde chair. Loin de nous, noir présage, les plus sages sont les fous.
You forgot to breathe.
I did.
Let's do that one more time, okay? One more time. One more time. Loin de nous, noir présage.
Loin de nous, noir présage. De nous, nos présages, les plus sages sont les fous.
Good, good. Stop there. So, it's great. The note is there. It's absolutely there.
I want it more, much more rich.
It's plenty rich. It is plenty rich.
Okay.
It's plenty rich. I think what I would advocate for, I feel like you're muscling up there much too much.
Yeah.
And you're preparing for that, and you have that high note in your mind as soon as you start singing, Loin de nous, loin de présage, loin de nous, loin de présage. And it's impossible to bring up that kind of heft up top. It's really difficult. We don't want to do that.
I know.
We don't want to do that. So you need to just think about inviting those head tones in a little bit more.
Okay.
Okay? So just in less heft, less muscle, and more release. I want you to think release, which in this context is obviously very difficult because I'm asking you to do something incredibly vulnerable. But I just want to see what would happen. What if you let go? And just allowed it to happen.
Absolutely.
Can we try? Loin de nous.
Loin de nous, noir présage. Loin de nous, noir présage. Les plus sages sont les fous.
So that's already much better.
Yeah.
And plenty rich, right? Plenty rich. I'm going to ask you to do one thing.
Okay.
Your tongue is really pulling back.
I felt that.
Really, really pulling back.
Yeah.
So again, within the context of release and releasing, what would happen if you just had a really, you know, Marlena used to tell me, have dead eyes. And I had a lot of trouble understanding what she meant by that, but you know, I think what that advocates for is just this sense of release, okay? Mm. Just the sense of we're getting out of our way, and the voice is happening, okay? All right, can we just blend in one more time?
Yeah, absolutely.
Tongue in the right place.
Loin de nous, nos paysages, les plus sages sont les fous.
So, yes, yeah. And when your tongue is in the right position there, your voice really pops beautifully. Can I ask you to do it again?
Sure.
Yeah?
Absolutely.
Great.
Loin de nous, nos présages, loin de nous, nos présages, les plus sages sont les fous.
So the more, you've got such a rich, warm, beautiful tone, the more you get out of your own way, the more we hear that.
Okay? Perfect.
Yeah, yeah. So when you do that, it's truly fantastic. Can we just, let's keep going. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
O vain dissipe la tristesse. O vain dissipe la tristesse qui pèse sur mon cœur. À moi le rêve de l'ivresse.
I just want you to think
L'ivresse.
I just want you to hear the difference, what happens when you do that. Douce-lique.
Douce-lique.
That is so much more resonant.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
I felt that.
It's right. It's like, oh, okay. Yeah, let's do that all the time. All the time.
Absolutely.
Okay, that's fantastic. Let's do it one more time.
Douce-lique. Douce-lique.
French nasal at the very end, okay?
Mm.
Okay, and then vers nous livra, not livre, livre,
vers nous livra.
No, back. Kraken dead.
Livra!
Livra! Right, okay. So just open that up. Tall, bright, lifted.
Okay. Absolutely.
Let's go back to the. Oh, actually, Dusalika. Dusalika, one more time.
Dusalika.
My name is Ayanna Platt, and today Spencer and I will be performing Song to the Moon from Dvorak's Rosalka.
Oh.
got such a fantastic voice. Really, really beautiful. And I think one of the things I loved about your performance in general was your stillness, you know, which is really a reflection of the character, right? So I thought that was really, really very, very brave of you to give us that vulnerability, and especially after sitting for so long. So that's really fantastic. That's really, really great. One of the thoughts I had in general was just, you know, for your pianos in general, I think we have to remember that we need to sing those over an orchestra.
Yeah.
Right? So, you know, a good tip I got was, you know, somebody once said to me that, you know, we need to think of the pianos not as necessarily as a dynamic marking, but as a certain kind of intention. So it's not that you're singing softly, but it's just that you're having, you know, a different thought, more or less. Because, you know, you can't sing it that way if you're going to be projecting out, you know, into the mat or something like that, right? Yeah. There really is no piano to speak of, unless you're singing, you know, a certain kind of repertoire. Yeah. So can we just start this again and just, can we just start with a little bit more core to the sound?
Yeah.
Whatsoever, right? So that's exactly the kind of, and in many ways it actually lands much more clearly from an emotional perspective, right? Because for us to hear the resonance of your voice and to feel that, it's special. It's special for the audience. We need that. We need to hear and feel that reverberation to get the emotion that you're trying to impart. Right?
Yeah.
Let's keep going. Just a little bit of jaw tension.
Yeah.
Just a little bit.
Yeah.
And I think if I may, if we, I don't want to get rid of the lift and the brightness and the clarity that you have, because that is very, very special, and that's what's going to allow you to carry over the orchestra. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we want to keep that 100%. But can you just invite yourself to just relax, just a hair, okay? Just a hair. And I think if we can also just think, when you go to that G flat, can you just think more of an ah-ish kind of vowel? Can we just try it? Can we go right on it?
Sure.
Got your voice in this, you know, 3D Technicolor, you know, all facets were firing, okay? And that's what we want all the time, okay?
Yeah.
So if you can just, and it's just such a slight adjustment, but it makes such a huge difference. If you can just think just a hair more vertically there, okay, and just allowing for that freedom, that jaw freedom as well.
Yeah.
And I think if you think of that as well in your middle voice, it's going to help you too.
Okay.
It was great. Let's do it again. Again. Yes. Oh. Just let it drop. Stop me whenever we need to stop.
Right. Let's go to the second verse.
Your tone just got a little bit breathy there.
Okay.
Just a little bit.
Yep.
And I think that happens when we try to be just a little bit too precious, a little bit too musical, okay?
Yep.
Again, simplicity. Sing what's on the page. Don't feel like you have to create some kind of color. The color's already in the music, okay? Let's just do one more time from that same spot. Core of the voice, right away. That's great. Wonderful. First note, right? Use it as a springboard. Take that really, really nice release breath, so just so we don't feel like we're running out of air, okay?
Yeah.
But that's great.
Okay.
That's great. That's great. All right. Let's go somewhere before then.
Do you want to go back to just the last phrase?
Let's do that.
Okay. So what I mean,
A little bit more release. Yes.
I'm so proud and so excited that you this is great, and you say so many great things, and you're such a wonderful artist and teacher. So we're happy to have you. You can come back anytime.